Hi, welcome to A Conversation with Billy Silicon, where we look for very interesting individuals that have become successful or are in a path of achieving their greatness, either through music, through poetry, through entrepreneurship, through speaking, through building all kinds of businesses, because we believe that when you have an open conversation with somebody, you get to get into the depth, or what we call deep diving, of understanding the essence of who this person is and why they do what they do, so that you, as our viewers, can not only see this as a hype, but as a proper conversation between two individuals where we get into understanding the journey of the person that I'm having a conversation with. I hope that you're inspired by these people that I'm interviewing as much as they inspire me. And today, we have a young man who's an entrepreneur. His name is Mholi Zulu, and he runs a media business, which he has started quite recently, and we'll let him introduce himself and go through his journey so far. Hi, Mholi. Welcome to A Conversation with Billy Silicon.
Hi, Billy. Nice to be with you.
So tell us about yourself. Who are you? You know, for somebody who's just seen you for the first time on television, and who are you and what do you do?
Oh, my name is Mholi. I'm a Durban boy, born and raised in Durban. So I'm an entrepreneur in the media space, and one of our key products is video. So we offer marketing solutions that are based around video. I'm sure that you know that video is the most powerful communication tool on the planet. And what we do is we look to build solutions for brands to help them better communicate with their clients using video.
So your background up to the time that you're now a video entrepreneur or a marketing entrepreneur, what inspired you to get into this business? Why not clothing like young people? Why not a DJ? Why specifically this industry and specifically using this particular tool, which is video? What inspired you to get to do this?
I think for a new business coming into the marketing space, it's a space that has a lot of players. So I think it was important for us to look at where can we make an impact? Where is there room for us to come in and play? And video has really grown as a communication platform with the advent of social media, with the advent of smartphones. I mean, everybody has a smartphone right now. So it really gave us an opportunity to be part of something that was growing and that was developing. And as brands encompass video more into their marketing strategy, and having video as something that's a central component of their marketing approach, rather than being just something that we do on the side, really gives us an opportunity to be one of the leading players in a market that's still developing, that's still growing.
You know, if you look at the world of adverts, you know, they're using, you know, neuroscience to craft messages that can impact people psychologically so that it can shape them to buy a particular product or align themselves to that product. So how different are you guys doing? Are you using the same advertising principles that follow neuroscience and that follow the psychology of buying, or are you guys coming with a different twist? Because I've seen some brands following almost like a movie, like a little docu movie, for the lack of a better explanation. Are you following the normal advert way, or are you bringing something that is completely new?
Firstly, we try and assess what the client is trying to achieve, and then we build a solution, which is of course based around video. But I think there's a lot of ways to structure it. Us coming from a communication background, we're very good at getting the message across. So there's a variety of ways of doing it. You can do it the old traditional way of advertising, selling your message, talking about your product, talking about its features. You can do video sponsorship. You can do documentaries. There are so many options out there, especially now with the growth of content marketing. So I think for me, that's actually the future, because instead of just putting your products in front of someone, why not create something that that person is going to enjoy or learn from, and then make your brand a part of that?
Cool. Yeah. Now, you know, if you look at South Africa, where we are now, there's big talk around youth entrepreneur, you know, like, oh, we must give young people opportunity in business, whatever. But what worries me is the lack of experience, is the lack of understanding how business work. Because, you know, I like to refer to people and say, you know, I'm not Mark Zuckerberg, I'm not Elon Musk, I'm not, you know, Steve Jobs. I have to really graft, I really have to, you know, roll my sleeves and work exceptionally hard for an exceptional long time for me to get where I am, and the journey still continues. But there's a perception in within young people that, it's going to happen, you know, next week you're going to drive a Range Rover, you're going to drink champagne. What is your take on that?
No, I think hard work is very important. And I also think that platforms like Global Conference, television, are really going to assist young people to get a better understanding of what it takes to become an entrepreneur. So I think even in our school system, I think there's definitely space for more incorporation of entrepreneurship into the curriculum so that we can develop the mindset.
So, you know, Mholi, one of the things that I've said, and like I'm saying, I'm not trying to choose one particular nationality,
sure,
but it's a fact. You know, if you look at Indians mentor their kids actively and inactively by the fact that their children, when they come from school, they come to a shop where they see their father trading, and they begin to learn that nuance of understanding how business works. And when they are older, it's easy for them to make a choice and get into business.
Not sure.
And yet, in African societies, especially in the South African context, not all our parents are business people. Some of them are drivers, taxi, you know, driving taxis. Some of them are domestic workers. And yet, there's this kind of, you know, for a lack of a better word, an illusionary way of thinking that just like that, you're going to get young people to become entrepreneurs.
Mm.
You know, where do you think we should start?
I think one of the challenges in some of the programs that that we have that try to encourage entrepreneurship, one of the problems is that these programs are run by people who are not entrepreneurs.
Exactly. All these agencies, these government agencies, are run by guys with degrees who've never even sold one chappies. And how do they understand entrepreneurship if they've never done anything themselves?
So that's where I think platforms like GCTV come in, where we can use the platforms that we have now. We can use the internet, we can use smartphones, we can use video to develop programs that schools and government can use. And these programs must be developed by entrepreneurs, people who have that mindset.
Absolutely.
People who've walked the path, people who know what it takes, who know the principles that one needs.
So your business in the video space, what is your vision? Where do you see your business 5-10 years from now?
Well, a recent study was done around video, and some of the stats are amazing. One of the stats is that by 2020, over 90% of the content on the internet will be video. So there's definitely room for growth for us. So we're really looking to grow. We're looking to do work in the entrepreneurial development space. We're looking to do work in the marketing space in developing solutions for some of the bigger companies. So for us, we really want to be one of the major players.
Now there's also this new reality, VR, you know, virtual reality. Have you guys looked at it? Because virtual reality is going to take video to the next level. So if you're in video and you're not looking at VR or augmented reality, you're not in the game, because that is absolutely phenomenal.
Absolutely, absolutely. I think it's something that we're looking at very closely, and I think it's something that, you know, the industry is still grappling with.
But how to go around it?
How to go around it?
You know, you can shoot virtual reality videos, but people need a device to. But
I guess the videos, yeah.
Like anything else, in the next 4 years, it's going to be normal. You know, so
absolutely,
gonna, their phone is going to be
absolutely
VR
no.
Able, yeah.
No, for us, it's definitely about staying ahead of the game because change is the constant, as they say. Right now.
Change is no longer the constant. Disruption is the constant.
Disruption.
Because things have been disrupted, you know, the Ubers of this world, the Airbnbs and those kind of things, the Netflix, so everybody's been turned upside down. Now, what is your message for young entrepreneurs out there, somebody starting his business today or her business today? What are words of wisdom that you'd like to share with them based on your experience and as your journey continues? What would you like to say to them?
Now, I would just say, you know, hard work, discipline and creativity. And also just learning as much as you can from people like yourself, from platforms like GCTV. So you need to invest in yourself to reach the levels that you want to get to. So,
and of course, forget instant gratification, because a lot of the young people, they want to spend their money now. They want to invest in themselves. So I always say that, you know what, the best investment you can make at a certain age, to a certain age, is in yourself. Because every dollar that you already put in yourself, you can quadruple it, or you can make it 10 times in a very short space of time.
Absolutely.
So unlike putting it on a car or stuff like that. Thank you very much, Mholi. We wish you all the best. And we're going to have this conversation again with you a year from now, 6 months from now, to see how far you've gone with your video marketing, and whether you're burning the market.
No, absolutely. And I just want to take this opportunity to congratulate you on GCTV. And definitely would like to see if we can work with you in the future.
No, definitely, yeah.
And also to people watching, if you're looking for a video solution to help you promote your business, to attract customers, you can check us out on promosonvideo.co.za.
Let's say it again. Check out his business, promosonvideo.co.za. No matter how small or how big your business is, video is the way to go. You want to reach your target market, you want to talk to them, you want to create a bit of a buzz. Video is the way to go. Statistically, they say by 2020, over 90% of the content everywhere in the world will be video-based. This is Billy Silicon saying, have an awesome day, and thank you for being with us.